Welcome students of class 9. Welcome in our e-learning classes of Badon Model School. Student, today I will solve question number 4 of exercise 8.2 of the chapter quadrilateral. In a parallelogram ABCD, parallelogram means opposite sides are equal and parallel. Okay. ABCD. Okay. ABCD. E and F are the midpoint of AB and CD. E is the midpoint of AB and F is the midpoint of CD. So that the line segment AF, so AF and EC bisect the diagonal BD. I am giving that name PB, P and Q. It means we have to prove that DP equal to PQ equal to QB. Okay. So ABCD is a parallelogram, E is the midpoint of AB, F is the midpoint of EC. We have to prove that the line segment AF and EC bisect the diagonal BD in equal three parts. It means DP equal to PQ equal to, in other words, we have to prove DP equal to PQ equal to QB. Now students, first of all, in triangle, first AB, as it is parallelogram, AB parallel to CD, AB parallel to CD, and A is the part of AB. So AE must be parallel to CF. A is part of AB and CF is the part of CD. Then automatically AE and CF are parallel. And another way, AB equal to CD. Why AB equal to CD? Because opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. Now AB by 2 and CD by 2. AB by 2 means that is A, and CD by 2 means CF. So look at the board. A parallel to CF and A equal to CF. Opposite sides are parallel as well as equal. It means AE CF is a parallelogram. It is clear. AE equal to CF. Why? Because AB equal to CD is the midpoint, F is the midpoint. So these two equal to, and also AB parallel to CD, A is part of AB and CD is part of CD. Then they are also parallel to each other. That's why AF is a parallelogram. Now students, in triangle ABP, that is the midpoint, midpoint of AB, then these two are parallel, as AE, CA parallel, this one are parallel to each other. Okay, so AE is the midpoint of AB. Okay, ABP is the midpoint of AB, and AEQ, just think about that, EQ parallel to AP. Why EQ is parallel to AP? Because EQ is part of CE and AP is part of AF, so they must be parallel to each other. So is the midpoint of EQ, by converse midpoint theorem, you can say Q is the midpoint of PB. Q is the midpoint of PB. Consider triangle ABP is the midpoint of AB, and this one is parallel to this and is the midpoint. By converse midpoint theorem, Q is the midpoint of PB. It means that is by M converse MPT. Okay, so Q is the midpoint of PB means BQ equal to QB. Okay, so another statement we get. Okay, next, now consider the triangle in DQC. DQC, F is the midpoint of DC. DC or CD? F is the midpoint of CD. Okay, as F is the midpoint of CD and these two are parallel, that is, that point is P. PA parallel to QC. PA parallel to QC and F is the midpoint. It means P is the midpoint of DQ. P is the midpoint of DQ. F is the midpoint of CD. Then automatically in this triangle, if P is the midpoint of DQ, it means DP equal to PQ. Okay, first taking angle triangle ABP is the midpoint, then Q will be midpoint, then PB equal to QP. Second, DQC, P is the midpoint, same F is the midpoint. So DP equal to F is the midpoint, then P is the midpoint. Okay, F is the midpoint of CD, then P is the midpoint of DQ. Therefore, DP equal to PQ. Now just think, DP equal to PQ and PQ equal to QB. Together, one and two, first and two boxes, DP equal to PQ equal to QB. Now we get the our required line. DP equal to PQ equal to QB. It means AF and EC trisect the diagonal BD. Trisect means divide in equal three parts, that is DP equal to PB equal to QB. Okay, so I have put the question number 4. Students, again I am repeating the from the beginning, AB parallel to DC, it means AE parallel to EC because part of line. So AB equal to CD, AE equal to FC because E and F are the midpoint. So AECF is a parallelogram. Next, consider triangle ABP is the midpoint. And this one EQ is parallel to AP because of parallelogram, because ABCF is a parallelogram. So EQ parallel to E is the midpoint, automatically Q is the midpoint of PB. So PQ equal to QB. Next, considering the triangle DQC, these two are parallel because this is the parallel of sides of AECF, and F is the midpoint of CD, automatically P will be midpoint of DP. That is why converts midpoint theorem. Again here, converts midpoint theorem, then we get DP equal to PQ. Now PQ equal to DP equal to PQ and PQ equal to QB. It means PQ equal to QB equal to DP. All are equal. It means AF and EC trisect the diagonal BD. So we have proved the statement. So students, I hope the concept is clear to you. If you have any problem, any doubt, you can ask me in e-portal. I will try to solve your doubt. Next video, we will solve question number 6 of exercise 8.2 coordinate. Thank you, students.